color splash, or the selective black and white look, is a popular image processing style that we can use to accentuate a strong colorful subject against a black and white background. In today's tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to pull off this trick on your mobile photos using the hidden Edit Stacks Masking Brush feature inside of Snapseed from Google. With Snapseed, this trick is easy to learn, and it's an excellent example of the types of sophisticated changes that we can make to our smartphone images once you understand how masking works in this app. Let's get started using this photo of my nephew that I shot with a Samsung Galaxy S6 smartphone. Now, my nephew is obviously the subject here, but the scene is cluttered. Since this is not an ideal studio environment, there are lots of distracting elements on the left side of my frame. I could crop the whole left side of this image away to center your attention on my nephew's face, but instead, I'm going to use the color splash effect to draw your attention away from all that distracting background stuff. To do this, I need to point out that we are starting with a full color photo. Step one for this example is to go to the Tools and Filters menu, and then I'm going to bring up the Tune Image toolset. When Tune Image loads, I'll tap on the Adjust icon down there on the toolbar, and then swipe down on the screen with one finger to choose the Saturation option. Running one finger all the way to the left now will drop the saturation down to negative 100. When we completely desaturate an image, all that is left is its black and white tonal skeleton. Not every image is going to need this next bit, but on this photo, I think that I will swipe up to the brightness control, and then I'll lower the brightness down to about negative 30. I'll tap on the check mark in the lower right-hand corner of the screen now to return to Snapseed's home screen. That part was easy, but as you can see, the whole image has become a black and white. To turn an all black and white image into a part black and white, I need to use the hidden Edit Stacks Masking Brush feature. So, I'll tap here on the Stacks icon, then on the words View Edits in the flyout menu, and then on that tiny little triangle that lives along the left side of the Tune Image layer. When the blue bar appears, remember that the Masking Brush mode is the symbol in the middle. One more tap here on this little brush icon, and now we are ready to create the color splash effect. At this point, my image has gone back to full color. Our make it into a black and white command is not active at this moment because we've not told the app where we want this change to happen. I could set my brush strength up to 100 by tapping on the increase button down there in the center of the toolbar, and then I could try and paint over the whole left side of this image. I'll demo this, but if you're playing along, hold on a second, because there's an easier way. See, right now, wherever I paint with the 100 strength brush, I'm telling this app to activate the make it black and white command. Wherever the brush goes, the image turns black and white. If I tap on the mask icon down there on the toolbar, you can see that the areas under the red rubolith are the places where I just painted. Remember that in this app, the red overlay in the mask represents the parts of the image where the change that this edit layer requires are visible. I'm going to switch to the zero brush by tapping on the decrease arrow a few times, and now I'll erase away my paint strokes because I want to show you a trick. Right now, there is no paint on my mask, so it appears as if nothing is happening. To turn nowhere into everywhere without having to paint a single drop, all that I need to do is to tap on the invert button over there on the left side of the toolbar. Now we have an all red overlay, and of course all red means that the change is active everywhere. When I tap on the mask button again, an all black and white image is what we see. So now, I'm going to use the two-finger pinch in move to make my image a little smaller. I'm doing this because in Snapseed, your brush tip size changes as you zoom in or out. Zooming out makes the brush tip larger. By the way, if you want to see your brush size, just press and hold two fingers against the screen. I'm going to tap here so that I have the zero strength brush. And now I'm going to paint over my nephew's face with the zero strength brush to keep this part of my image in full color. If I need to clean things up a little more, then I can toggle the mask on again and zoom in a little. If there are areas that I missed that need to be in color, then I'll paint more with the 0% brush. If I've gone too far, like in this area over here, then I can switch the brush strength around, and now I can paint over those mistakes so that they become black and white. If I wanted to, I could keep zooming in and painting with a finer and finer brush tip to be more precise, but I don't think that this image needs it. I'm gonna tap on the check mark in the bottom right to commit my work and return to the stack screen. One more tap on this left-facing arrow will bring me back to Snapseed's home screen, and now I could save my work. The color splash effect was easy to create on this image, and as you can see, that black and white background is far less distracting. In a photo like this one, your eye will always be more attracted to the colorful stuff than the parts of the image that have faded down to black and white. Let me show you one more example. Here's a travel shot that I took one day just outside of the Valley of Fire State Park in Nevada. As you can see, this is a full color image, and I've already tuned this shot up to get ready for today's demo. I like the way that this one looks in color, but if we add that color splash treatment, then I think we can make this photo even more unique. Just like last time, the first step is to tap on the Tools and Filters button, only this time I'm going to swipe down and use the black and white filter to give myself a more powerful starting point. When the black and white filter loads, I'm going to tap on the color filter icon on the left side of the toolbar. I like to tap my way through the color filters until I've found the ideal starting point. Ooh, I like green. Yeah. Next, I'm going to tap on the adjust icon, and then I'll set the contrast up to about plus 15. Now we have a strong, moody black and white. I'm happy, so I'll tap on the check mark to commit this change. Once again, the change that this edit layer initially makes in Snapseed is happening everywhere. For the color splash look, though, I need to hold the convert to black and white command back from certain parts of the image. So I'll tap on the stacks icon again, then on view edits, and then on the little triangle beside the black and white edit layer. One more tap on the masking brush icon, and now I'm ready to do the color splash thing. Just like last time, I'm going to start by tapping on the invert button so that my mask becomes completely red. With an all red mask, the black and white conversion is happening everywhere. Now, I need to paint over the parts of the image that should remain in color. In this case, I want the yellow lane marker lines that run through the center of the road to remain in color. I'm going to start by setting my brush strength down to 0, and then I'll use the two-finger push-out move to zoom in a bit. I'm going to keep zooming in until my brush tip is about the size of one lane marker. Now, I can paint over the bottom edge of this image to keep these stripes in color. As the road recedes in towards the background, the yellow lines get narrower. So, I'm going to need to zoom in again to change my brush size as I paint along each little segment. At this point, I also need to use the navigator to move the image around the screen so that I can see more of the road. As the road fades into the distance, I'm going to have to keep zooming in to change the size of my brush. At about this point, I'm going to tap on the increase button to change the brush strength. For this next stretch of road, as it fades into the distance, I'm going to paint with the 50% brush. At the far horizon, when I've zoomed in as far as I can, I'll do a little painting with the 75% brush. Each time that I increase the brush strength, I'm allowing a little more of the fade to black and white command to mix with the underlying image. To clean things up, I like to turn on the mask again, and then I'll set the brush up to 100%. 100% here meaning wherever I paint now, show 100% of the black and white image. A little more cleanup and you get the idea. Let me turn the mask off and then you can see what we have created. Voila! I could keep zooming in and cleaning things up all day, but I think that you get the idea. I'm happy now, so I'm going to tap on the check mark to commit my work. With just one edit layer, we have gone from this to this using the masking brush in Snapseed. If I may offer one final suggestion before I sign off, it's to use this effect only on images where the thing that you want to keep in color is easy to paint over. Unless you have endless free time, please don't try this trick on an image where you need to paint over every leaf on a tree or every face in a crowd of hundreds. Save this effect for shots where the painting is easy. I hope that you found this tutorial useful. The color splash effect is just one more example of the incredible things that you can do in Snapseed as you begin to take your masking brush skills to the next level.